Guys, my name is Bhushan. I welcome you to my YouTube channel. In our previous lecture, we have completed the update operation. So in this lecture, let's do the delete operation. So flip to our Eclipse IDE. First of all, the idea of this delete operation is whenever the user click on this delete link, we will send the student ID to a controller. On the controller, we will send the student ID to a DAO. On the DAO, we will search for the student object using that student ID. And once we got the student object, we will bring that student object back to controller. So then we will send that student object to a DAO, and there we will delete the student object. So this is the whole idea of the delete operation. But we have already written a private method that is find by ID. So for the find by ID method, we will pass the student ID, and there we will get the student object. Let's do that. So flip to our Eclipse IDE. So let's write our actual method. Public string delete student object, and this will accept a student ID. For that we will use a add request param. So we have to specify a student ID. Like I said, we have to specify a same name as we have specified in our list students JSP, that is student ID, and this will accept the student ID as a parameter. And for this student ID, we will pass it to a DAO. But we have already written a private method, that is find by ID. For this, we will pass a student ID, and this will give us a student object. Now we will pass this student object to a DAO. So for that, let's call a service method using a student service object. Service dot delete student object. For this we will pass a student object. So let me create this method in our service, and in our service interface we have declared this delete student object method, and in our service implementation let's add unimplemented methods, and above our method let's specify add transactional annotation, and here we will call the DAO method using a student DAO object delete student object. For this we will pass a student object. Let's create this method in student DAO. Let's declare this method in student DAO interface, and in student DAO implementation let's add unimplemented methods. So here first of all let's get the current session using a session factory. Session factory dot get current session. On this get current session we will call a delete method. So for this delete method we will pass a student object. So that's it. So the Hibernate will take care of it. So let me stop the server. Before that let's go back to our student controller. Let's specify a request mapping. This is a very important request mapping. The value we will specify as we have specified in our list students JSP, that is delete record. Copy this and paste it here. Alright, let's save this, and also we have to, so the string that we are going to return is redirect list students. Alright, so when the user delete the record we have to display the same JSP. For that we will return a string that is redirect colon slash list students. So let's save this and stop the Tomcat, and let's restart the Tomcat. So go back to our browser and reload the browser. So let me click on this list of students. Let's try to delete any one of these records. Let me delete John. So click on delete. The record has been deleted. So that's all about this video. We have covered all the operations, that is add, delete, update and list the students. In our next video what we will do is when the user clicks on delete button we have to ask a confirmation message saying that are you really want to delete this record. So that we will implement it in our next video. And also we have to fix one more issue, that is when the user clicks on update link we have to pre-populate the values. In this case the checkbox's values are not checking, so we will fix this issue in our next video. So thank you so much for watching. I will see you in next video.